Hi, this is Tutorials by LV, and today we're going to make this owl chick. I have made several owls from many different types, and you can also use this design to make a baby owl for my parrot design that I posted earlier. So let's get We are going to start with the wing. My wing is going to be all brown, but you can make it whatever colors you want. All the bands on the wing are going to be double looped. So take one single band and twist it around your hook once so you have two rings. And we're going to go down with double looped bands five times on the right side of your loom. So one, two, three, four, and five. So stop there, and we're gonna start on our center, and we're gonna go down four times this time instead of five, again with double loop bands. So one, two, three, and four. Should look like this. We're gonna start on the third row, and this time we're gonna go down three times. So one, two, and three. Make sure your bands look good, and now we're going to push them down and put on holding bands. Our holding bands are going to be double looped, so take one and loop it once around your hook and make a triangle. Do it again, loop it around your hook and make a triangle that's pointing in the opposite direction. Alright, so now we're going to do capping bands. Our capping bands are going to be looped around our hook or peg four times. If you can only do it three times, that's fine. It will work too. So, looped it around my hook or peg four times. It works the same. Putting it on the end. Looping it around four times. Looping it around four times. And now we are going to start looping. So reach under the capping band, grab the bottom band, and loop up. It's gonna look like two bands, but it's actually one. And then reach under, loop up, under, loop up. Don't loop the holding band, grab the bottom band, loop up. Again, don't loop the holding band. Grab the bottom band and loop up. Do it again for the other side. Loop, reach under the capping band, grab the bottom band and loop up. Reach under, loop up. Reach under, loop up. Reach under and loop up. Do the same. Reach under the capping band, grab the bottom band and loop up. Reach under the holding band and loop up. Again, reach under the holding band, don't want to loop it, and loop up. Okay, so now we're going to put it aside on our hook. So just stick your hook through the three loose ends and take it off your loom. You should see three sets of four loops, and we're gonna squish them together, but we're gonna make sure that we can still see the difference, because that's gonna be important when we're gonna put it on our body. So set aside your wing, and now we're gonna start with the body. Take two bands and start from the center peg out. from the center to the left and go down on the left once, all with two bands, and go down on the other side. And then in the center, go down. And again, on the center. And then go from each side and go into the center. And from each side into the center. So now we have like this hexagon circular thing on our loom. And now that's gonna be the head. So now we're gonna start on the body. We're gonna go from the center out, and from the center out to on the other side. And then we're gonna go down two times. So one and two. And do it on the other side. One, two. And on the middle, go down three times. So one, two, and three. And stop there, because now we're going to make our feet. Mine are going to be black. You can make it whatever color. I'm going to take one band, and I'm going to loop it around my hook four times. So you see four rings around your hook. Do this one more time. One band around your hook four times. And then we're going to take one single band, and we're going to slide those bands that we just put on our hook onto that band. Make sure you get all the parts of that band. And then put one side of that band on your finger, and then the other side on your hook. And we're going to take another band and wrap it around our hook four times. And then put on the side that was on our finger. So we kind of have a band sandwiched between two others. It should look like this. And there's our foot. Now take two bands and slide all the bands from your foot onto it. The two bands should be the color of your bird's body. So, slide all those bands onto it. And put it on just as if it were a normal band to the center. And you're going to want to do this one more time. So you have two feet. And, sorry, I forgot to mention, you should have done two wings. And so take that one foot and do the same, just like a normal band. Slide down all of your bands so that we can put on holding bands. Our holding bands are going to be two bands, like so, in a triangle, and then another two bands in a triangle. Okay, so now we're gonna put on our wings. We're gonna take, remember what I said about having sets of four loops? We're gonna take one of those sets of four loops, and we're gonna put it on this peg right here. And then we're gonna take another set of those four loops, and we're gonna put it on this peg. Another set, should be the last one, on this peg. Make sure that the longest row of your wings is on the top and the shortest is on the bottom. And then we're gonna do this for the other wing. Take one set and put it on this peg. Another set and put it on this peg. If you want to, you can just do it loop by loop onto the peg, as long as you only get that one set onto the peg. Alright, so now I have all four. And I'm going to put the last set onto the bottom. And again, make sure that the longest row is on the top and the shortest is on the bottom. Okay, so now we're going to cap it off. And if you saw that these two bands changed color, that's okay. I just forgot that they were supposed to be white. But if you did brown, it's fine. It won't change the design at all. Okay, so for our capping band, loop it around your hook or peg 4 times. If you can't do it 4 times, do it 3 times. It'll still turn out the same. Got that one didn't turn out well. I put it on. Alright. So now we're gonna make his beak. I'm gonna have the bands be black. You can make it whatever color. And I'm gonna wrap the one band on my hook 4 times, just as if we were doing a capping band. And then take a band, double loop it, stretch it out, and slide the band that you just wrapped around your hook onto it. So there's our beak. And we're gonna take 2 bands of your body color and we're gonna put our beak onto them. Make sure you get all the parts of the beak. And then we're gonna stretch those bands in between these 2 pegs on the face. And now for the eyes, for the center of the eyes, I'm going to do black, so you can see how the eyes are kind of two-toned, like so. I'm going to make mine the same color, like so. And so wrap it around your hook 4 times, do it again for the other eye, wrap it around. And then for the outer part of our eyes, we're going to take 1 band and wrap it around once so it's kind of on the bottom. Sorry, take that 1 band, the black one, off of your hook because it's not going to work out on your hook. And so you have 2 loops on this side of your eye. And then we're going to wrap it around another 2 times on the other side. And now we're going to put that band that we just took off back on. Wrap it around 4 times. Take our outer eye color. Wrap it around once on the bottom and twice on the top. So now we have our eyes. And we're going to take 2 bands of body color and slide our eyes onto it. Could take some practice. For some of the beginners have trouble with this. Just pause the video if I'm going too fast. Okay, so now we have our eyes on our 2 bands and we're gonna stretch them between these 2 pegs. And separate your eyes and take 2 parts of that band, 2 bands that we put our eyes on, and pull it down to the center peg. Okay, so now we have all the bands placed. Now we're gonna start looping. So reach under your capping band. Grab the bottom 2 bands and loop them over to the side, the right. Grab the next top 2. Make sure you only have 2 and loop them over to the side. Grab the bottom ones and loop them up. Again, grab the bottom ones, loop up, bottom ones, loop up, stop there, and then reach under all these bands and grab the bottom two. Loop up. Just be careful, as these bands can break easily. And then grab, reach under the bottom bands, grab the bottom two. Alright, so now reach under, grab the bottom two bands, loop up, stop there. Go back down to the bottom, reach under, grab the bottom two bands, and loop up. Make sure it's only two bands. Reach under, grab the bottom two bands. Make sure you got all of them looped. Reach under, grab the bottom two. And now reach under and grab the top two bands. And loop to side, under, grab the top two. And loop to side, grab the bottom two. And loop up. Make sure, just ignore the beak, just make sure it's pulled outwards. And then reach under the eye bands, grab the bottom two, loop up. Reach under and loop up. Reach under and loop up. Again, with all of these, reach under, grab the bottom two, loop up. Alright, so now we're done with our owl. We just have to slip knot it. So take one band and stick your hook through all the bands on this peg and grab that one band. Pull it through and put both sides on your hook. And grab the one that's closest to you and loop it over. Pull it tight and take your owl off the loom. Alright. See how he turned out. Grab the beak so it's sticking out. Pull out the eyes. And to fix your wings, if they're pointing the wrong direction, just stick your hook through all the bands on the wings and then pull opposite of the direction you want it to bend. And then take your hook out and it should be bending. And so there's our owl. It's so cute. If you want to, you can make like a bunch of other owls. And so you can, like, make the owls from Guardians of Gahool, or make all the owl types that you like, or make babies for my parrot tutorial. And just a heads up for all of our subscribers, we will be posting exclusive pictures for our new designs and new tutorials ahead of time on our Facebook and Instagram, and then we would also love it if you posted pictures of all of your owls or any of your creations of Pokemon. They don't even have to be Pokemon from our channel. We just love to see them. And thanks for watching!